Hello everybody. I wanted to show you this really cool tool for exploring the world's languages at the University of Maryland Language Science Center, but I had a hard time describing how to use it in text, so I thought I'd try my hand at my first screen capture video. So we'll see how this goes. I hope you enjoy it. To get into the map, you click go, and there you have a map of the world with all these little areas with borders around them. Those are language areas, and you can see some countries have a lot, some countries have fewer. The United States, as you can see, is mostly one big area of English, but there are some other languages in there. Let's see what we've got. Double click on it to zoom in, and we see over here Navajo come in. There's some other ones, though, like this pretty sizable blob right there. I don't know what that is. So we click on it and see TOHONO OODHAM. We click on that. It zooms us into the area, and then we can find more information about it. So if we scroll within the map, we move the map that like that. But if we scroll outside the map down here, you can scroll down and see some information about this language. TOHONO OODHAM is a Udo Aztecan language. It's got some alternate names, some dialects, vigorous use in the West and South, 9,600 speakers in the United States, so it's doing pretty well. If we click over here, we can find grammatical information, some sample texts, some interlinear glosses. We can see the grammar, figure out how to say, is the cowboy working in this language? If we click on these musical notes here, we can hear what it sounds like. There's a sound file here. We click on that. Very cool. Scroll down here, and this is where you can pause the media player if you want to stop the sound. Not every language will have sound files, but many of them do. Zoom back out and see something else here. If we scoot over to Louisiana, you can see some Cajun French. Let's hear what that sounds like, get some information. Scroll down. 17,200 speakers. That's very good. We click on here. There is a recording. Let's hear that.
Cette histoire ici, mes amis, est-ce que tu es sûr pour le ciel? C'est quelque chose qui est important. Quelque chose que pour une personne jonglée de si. Dans Jean 14, verset...
Hey, that's a very different kind of French. Very cool to hear that. And there's this other area in there, this small area. I wonder what that is. Click on that. We see KOASATI, another language in Louisiana. Click on that. And you see it's also over here in Texas. See some information about it. That's a Muskogean language in Louisiana and Texas. Not many speakers left, but good to have this information here. Dictionary, grammar, where you can find all these things. So this is just a real fun tool to play around with. And I've learned a lot scooting around with it. I like to try to go in where there's seemingly just one or two languages. You start zooming in, and sometimes you'll see pop up these little tiny areas. Go in and see, what is that? What's going on in that tiny area? Click on it. There in Lithuanian, in the Lithuania, there's a language called Karaim. What is that? Just right there. A Turkic language in Lithuania. So I had to go look and see what that was, and it turns out it's this little community, a Jewish sect that has been there since the 14th century, And the language, they had their own language, which was spoken there. Not many speakers left, but just really interesting history can pop up by finding these little linguistic islands in the world. It's also fun to go and see many areas of the world where there's a high density of languages. Scoot over here, you see how many languages there are in Indonesia, for example. In these tiny islands, so many languages. Or here in southern China, zoom in there, you see all these languages come into focus, and you can explore them. Here's this tiny blob. What is that? Click on it. I think it's this. MIEN. And when you click on it, you can see all the other ones, and you see here that it's scattered all throughout southern China. And you can find out some information about it. 383,000 speakers. That's not a tiny language. You can listen to it. Lots of sound files on this one. Pick one. Very different kind of sounding language. Very interesting to hear that. And interesting to see the way that it's scattered throughout the region. So all kinds of fun things to do with it. Once again, it's langscape.umd.edu. I'll put a link in, of course, at the Maryland Language Science Center. And it's a great resource, a great way to explore the world's languages, and a great way to see just how much linguistic diversity there is out there. So I hope you'll check it out and have a good time with it. Thanks.